Welcome to sports, everybody. The Government Basketball League Best of Five Championship tipping off last night at the Donald Davis Gym. It was a matchup of one versus two as the Police Crime Stoppers took on the BEC Shockers, and something had to give with both teams making it through without losing a single game in the playoffs. Trailing 38-31 at the half, Vernon Stubbs getting the Crime Stoppers off to a fast start in the third quarter. This baseline move good for two. On the other end, Nipsey Jones dialing it up from downtown. Ishmael Curtis with the ball now. He takes it inside, and the runner is good. Dario Seymour thinking about the three, but he steps inside the line and hits the long two. Crime Stoppers not doing a good job on the defensive boards, and BC made them pay. Vaccaro Clark off the glass. With time running out in the quarter, Vernon Stubbs going to take this one straight to the hole. The and one, he finished with a game-high 23, but the Police trail 55-45, heading to the fourth. Police looking for the steal here, but Curtis takes this one inside for two more of his side-high 18 points. Off the turnover, BC getting the ball to Dr. P. Perry Darling. Hoop and the foul, and the crowd's loving it. Police coach Anthony Copps rolled, not happy with the way things are going, and he lets the table know about it. Down 12 late in the game, the Police not about to give up. However, their comeback was too little too late. BEC goes on for the 73-70 victory, taking a 1-0 lead in the series.
Our defense needs to step up and stop turning over the ball. But we got a lot of work to do, but we know we can beat this team. We just got to pull together and play as a team.
It's one for the fans and one for a gift to BEC. Look, we're the champions. 3 years. And all of three of them, we lose the first game. So there's no stress, no pressure. We missed about more than 30 free throws.
What's the game plan now as you head into game two?
Keep the ball out there, point guard on. You know, once again, control the boards.
We'll be back on Thursday. And you know, it's a minor prediction. Okay, so we can take the backdoor sweep on them.
Well, after a successful third annual law enforcement basketball challenge earlier in the year, proceeds being put to good use today, we get that story from Charles Fisher.
Proceeds from the third tournament going to good use. Respective district superintendents from the 8 government junior schools receiving funds to assist with the lunch program for the less fortunate kids. TG Glover Primary receiving an extra gift, one from their former student and law enforcement basketball tournament organizer, Paul Smith.
I want to present this check to you for $5,000. It's not PE. It's not anything to do with the school and sports. Strictly for those children who really need. So on behalf of the Metro Telecom, we accept this check.
We are indeed sincerely grateful to Mr. Paul Smith and indeed Corporate Bahamas for partnering with the government to assist in meeting the needs of the students of TG Glover Primary School.
Guest speaker Pastor Eric Danny Clark had the attention of the students in the theme of today's assembly, Never Give Up.
All of us have to realize that, boys and girls, we can't allow ourselves to give up. If you keep on trying, you will discover that even though you started the game with double blank, when Christ finishes with you, you will have double six.
On bringing the keynote remark was Senator the Honorable Keith Bell, Minister of State for National Security.
That I wish to commend Mr. Smith again and all those who take part in the law enforcement basketball tournament, which at this current time is an all-male tournament. We hope very soon to change that to have a female component. And so I wish to commend all of you for the fine work that you're doing, not so much so for the tournament, but for what you do for persons in need. And your contribution today, certainly to TG Glover, speaks volumes of what everyone in our community can do. It takes a hand.
Good gesture. For ZNS Toll Sports, I'm Charles Fisher.
All right, thanks a lot, Charles. Well, the 2012 Bahamas Optimist Sailing Championships will take place this coming Friday and Saturday on waters off Harbor Island. The event will feature the best young skippers from around the country going head-to-head for national bragging rights.
Expecting over 80 boats from all the different islands in the Bahamas We've got a great team of sailors that are going to be representing Eleuthera and Governor's Harbor. There'll be a green fleet for the new sailors and a championship fleet consisting of the red, white, and blue sailors, dependent upon their ages. It should be a lot of fun, a great weekend.
The Harbor Island Sailing Club is a fairly young club, and we've come a long way in such a short time. And our team this year would be comprised of about 34 sailors.
This weekend, we hope to be a great weekend. We're looking for the Harbor Island Sailing Club to be winners. We want to win everything, take everything. Long Island, we're ready for you.
That's right.
Nassau, we're ready for you.
Grand Bahama, we're ready for you.
I'm hoping to do well, but there's definitely a very hard competition.
The Ministry of Tourism is excited about the Opti National Championships this weekend because it's an event that actually is a prelude to the North Eleuthera Regatta that takes place here next weekend. We will be expecting at least 200 people that will come on island just for this event. They will be a combination of the junior sailors as well as their parents and friends that will come to cheer them on. We recognize that encouraging the youth in any activity is a growth of tourism to the various islands. We expect that these youngsters will eventually be the mature sailors that you see during the various regattas taking place around the islands.
And that will do it for sports.